I'm going to show you how to build a brick letterbox. Brick letterbox creates a wonderful feature for your garden. It's generally the first thing that people see when they come on your yard, so it creates wow factor for your front yard. Tools we need for the job are our levels, our shovel, our handsaw, our bricklaying equipment, which consists of our brickies trowel, our bolster, our hammers, and of course a brush, our trowels, and our squares. The materials we need for the job are our concrete for our footing and our slab, our PVC pipe for our newspaper holder, our bricks, and of course our bricky sand and our cement for laying the bricks. We also need our utility knife and a pencil, our safety equipment, a cement mixer to mix our mortar, and of course the components to the letterbox. Now we can get started on building our letterbox. The first step is to select an appropriate spot for your letterbox. Make sure you consult with your local authorities to get your specifications on your footing and your slab. Once you've picked your location, you'll need to take measurements, and then you can go ahead and prepare your slab. The measurements will depend on what size you want your letterbox and what regulations the local authorities have given you. I'm happy with my measurements. Now it's time to start digging out for our footings and our slab. As you're digging for your footing, just be aware of any pipes and surfaces that may be running through the ground. Now I'm happy with my depth for our footing. It's time to start mixing up our concrete for our footing and our slab. Now it's time to mix our concrete. It's just as simple as mixing it in the barrow till it's a consistency that you're happy to work with. Now we've got our concrete mix, it's time to put it down a hole and start preparing our footing and our slab. Now we've got the cement in the hole, it's time to level it off and trowel it off smooth. Now that's nice and level and smooth, we're going to let it go off for 24 hours and set, and then we're right to start building our brick ladder box. Now the concrete slab's set, it's time to start laying our bricks. The first step is to do your set out for where the bricks are going to go. The required distance we need between the bricks is 10mm. I know that my brick rake's 10mm, so I'm just using that as a handy little packer just to go in between the bricks. So now we just take our roofing square, put it on each corner just to make sure our set out's square. Now that we know it's square and we're happy with our gaps, it's just a simple case of getting your pencil and then just doing a mark around the outside edge of your bricks. Now that we've got our pencil mark on the ground, we just remove the bricks away. Now we're going to go ahead and mix our mortar. We're doing a ratio of 6 to 1, which means 6 sand, 1 cement. Now that we've got our mortar mixed, I'm happy with the consistency. We're going to go ahead and pour it into the barrow to put on our mud board. I'm going to need a hand with that, so I've got my mate James to come and give me a hand. Just before you go ahead and lay the bricks, just give it a bit of a sweep so you've got a nice clean surface to start off. So now we've got our mortar mix, it's time to start laying our first course. It's just a simple case of getting your mortar off the board onto your trowel, and then rolling your trowel, and then troweling it onto the concrete slab. Now feather it out. Now we go ahead and sit our brick down on the mortar that we've just placed, making sure that it lines up with the lines. So now that we've got our first brick in place, we just put the level on top of it like that, making sure it's level, and just tap it down where you need to make it level. I'm happy with that, so we'll go ahead and lay our second brick. Now it's just a case of getting your second brick, getting some mortar, and then buttering up the end like that, and then putting it in place. Now we just carry on and go ahead, and then just do the rest of the square for the first course. Once again, get the level and just make sure the brick's level. Now that we've got our first course done, as we bring up the pier, we just place some bricks in the middle so it's not a hollow pier. Now there's no need to mud them up, just place them in the middle. Now that we've got our first course done, we're going to go ahead and do our second course. Just remember to stagger the joins as you come up with your pier. So by staggering the joins, I mean just place your brick so it's over the top of the previous join, so your joins don't line up as you're coming up the pier. It's also a good idea, as you're bringing up your courses for your pier, just make sure it's plumb, so it's all nice and straight for your letterbox. I'm happy with that, so I'm going to go ahead and lay the rest of our second course. So now that we've got the second course on, it's just also a good idea to check that it's still square. Once I'm happy that it's square, then I'll continue doing our next courses up until I put the newspaper holder in. So I've got enough courses up now, so now we're going to put our newspaper holder in. It consists of our two pieces for our newspaper holder. We've got a front and a back, and also a PVC pipe that we've got to cut to length. So now it's just a simple case of measuring your letterbox, So you get the distance and then cutting your PVC pipe. So now that we've got our pipe cut to length, it's just a simple case of putting your two ends in like that, using the margins on your bricks to line it up, making sure it's center and square. Now that we've got it in position, I'm happy with that. We're just gonna go ahead and lay our courses. Now, as you can see, we've got to cut a brick to fit there. Now I'll go ahead and show you how to cut the brick. Now we take our bolster and our lump hammer and just sit that on the marks you've got. And then just give it a hit with your lump hammer, a nice hard hit so you get a clean break through the brick. Now we're going to need four bricks cut, so you just go ahead and cut the other three and repeat the same process. Now that we've got our newspaper holder cut to length, we're going to remove it and start to mud up for our next course. So now that we've got our two outside bricks on, we're going to go ahead and put our newspaper holder in place and fill it in with the bricks that we've cut. So now that I've got our newspaper holder in position, it's just very important that you keep the front and back plate in line with the bottom of that course there. Now we'll go ahead and mud up for our next course. Now that we've got it mudded up, we're going to have to cut four bricks for each corner. So now that we've got our brick cut, we go ahead and put it in position. Now we'll go ahead and repeat the process for the other three corners. So now that we've got all the courses around our newspaper holder, we're going to go ahead and do one more course around the top. It's just important to remember to fill up the cavity around the newspaper holder with mortar. Now it's time to put our letterbox in. Ours comes in a kit form. There are several types of letterboxes you can get. I'm just going to show you how to assemble it. It comes in two parts, a front and a back. Now we've got both of them assembled. It's just a simple case of sleeving them inside like that. Now we've got it assembled, we put it in position and just do some final adjustments. It's important to remember to make sure that it's in the center of the outside dimensions of the column. Now we've got our letterbox in position, we'll go ahead and put mortar on it and do our last course. So now that we've got our last course in our letterbox, we'll just go ahead and smooth over the top with the mortar to give us a nice smooth finish for rendering. Now if you didn't want to render it, you could go ahead and rake out the bricks and then just have the raw brick look. Now I'll just brush it down with my brush to get rid of any excess mortar that's hanging out, and that's how you build a brick letterbox.